Benchmarking is a very important part of right-sizing your workloads and analyzing the workloads that you have. Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined by Gianluca, based in Italy, and he's going to tell us a little bit more about workload tools. Before we get into it, you know, I just wanted to welcome you for being on the show.
Thank you for having me.
And why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm a data platform MVP, and I've been working with SQL Server for a lot of time, 20 years. I started with version 7, so this means I'm old. And currently, I'm working as a DBA at a famous Formula One team in Italy.
Awesome. Well, thanks again for joining us. And as we kind of shift into workload tools, I just want to understand first, you know, what is a benchmark and why is it important?
Okay, so we can say that a benchmark is something that describes the performance of your system in a given scenario. So if I went to your server and I took a picture of how performance looks like, that's a benchmark. And this is useful because you can take different benchmarks in different scenarios and then you can compare the two. This is useful, example, when you have to upgrade something in your software stack. It could be SQL Server itself or any other part of your software stack. But this is also useful when you change something in your hardware, like the storage or the machine that runs the workload. This is also useful for other scenarios like virtualization or migration to the cloud or to a different data center. It is also interesting to compare benchmarks when you want to rate your tuning efforts. So you change something at the database level or at the server level or something in the code or adding indexes, changing views or store procedures, and you want to see how that performs compared to the baseline that you recorded initially.
Awesome. So it sounds like benchmarking is really important and also applicable to, you know, various number of scenarios. So now benchmarking, it seems like this is a concept and an idea that's been around for a while. You know, over the years and as we go from SQL Server to Azure SQL, are there challenges that have arisen over time or has it been kind of, you know, the same process through and through?
Well, the challenges have to do with the tools, basically. So both the tools that we have in our hands, and these are typically tools that come from Microsoft itself, but also the way the process is done. And I have a slide here that I can show you about the process. Okay, so imagine that you have your production database here. What you traditionally do is record a workload using a trace file or an extended events session to some files. And then you have to wait for the capture to finish, which has to last for a meaningful amount of time. And at the end of the capture, you have to process these files. And the result is an analysis of the workload that goes into an analysis database, and then some stub files that you can use to replay the workload against a test database. And while the replay is running against the test database, you also capture a second set of files, and you again have to wait for the capture to finish, and then again, process these files, write to the analysis database again, and then you can run your reports on top of that database to see how the two workloads stack against the other. And this is a bit problematic for a couple of aspects. First of all, the disk could fill. You have to capture a lot of files, and this is typically very big files that capture a lot of events. And then you have to process these files. And usually what happens here is that some of the tools like RML utilities or distributed replay tend to crash when the files are too big. So in order to overcome these limitations, I created WorkloadTools. This is a set of open source tools that take care of all the aspects of benchmarking, like capturing the workload, analyzing the workload, and replaying the workload against a test database. And also, we have two unique features in workload tools, not found in the traditional tools from Microsoft. It can work against an Azure SQL database or an Azure managed instance, and also can do real-time replays. So you don't have to wait for the workload to finish. You can start replaying it right away. So let's see how this works. You could be capturing a workload to analyze it with workload tools. So again, we have the production database, and then we have SQL workload, which is one of the tools in workload tools. And instead of having to capture all the events before you can analyze them, you can stream them directly using an incremental load of Excel files or trace files, or even using the streaming API for extended events. And all these events can go directly to an analysis database. And also, all the queries get normalized. Normalized means that all the literals found in the queries are stripped away and replaced by some placeholders, so that queries that differ only for the values of the literals can be grouped and analyzed together. And then you can use some reports, there's a reporting tool included in workload tools, to analyze and visualize the data from the analysis database. How does this look like? Here, an example of this. This is a reporting tool pointed to the analysis database, and it contains the CPU and duration over time of the workload. And we also have an indication of the batches per second. But an interesting part of the workload analysis is here. We can rank the queries by total duration or total CPU and see which ones are those that have the highest numbers by CPU duration or number of executions and so on. So we can see what is the shape of the workload to analyze it. Other activities you can do with workload tools is saving the workload to a file. So again, we have the production database, SQL workload that receives all the events. And instead of analyzing the events, we can save them to a file. So we can use these events as a source for, again, SQL workload. So we can use it to stream the events again from this file and repeat the analysis or even the replay. And again, we can have a look at the results from the reporting tools. And the most important part of workload tools, the most important feature is how it performs replays. So again, production database, SQL workload in the middle receives all the events incrementally. And then you can start analyzing as we did previously. We write the data to the analysis database, but now we also do, at the same time, the replay against the test database. We have, this time, a second instance of SQL workload that received this, all the events as for the production database, and we can write these events to the analysis database, so we can now compare the two. We don't have to wait for all the files to arrive for the workload to be recorded fully before we can analyze it. We can start replaying right away and analyze both workloads from production and from test at the same time. So this allows us to run for several hours, as I did here. I can show you what it looks like when the tool runs for several hours. This time we have two series of data baseline is green and benchmark is black, and this is an example running for 7 hours, and we can see how this looks like, so we can maybe zoom in to have a look at this part of the workload and see what it looks like here. And if we have a look at the queries, now we have more columns, and we have also the difference of the two workloads. So we can see, example, the duration. This is a difference of the total duration. And this is a regression. So we can start tuning this workload from this query, because this is the most promising one, the one that has the worst regression. All these can be configured using JSON files. And there's a couple of information that has to be filled in JSON files to configure a SQL workload. And you have to fill in data for listeners, so where the events come from, and consumers, so what you want to do with events that you are capturing. So in this case, we are saving an analysis to target analysis database, but we could also be doing different things like running a replay or a real-time replay. And this is what it looks like for a replay, for example. This also works against Azure SQL database as we have here. So basically, this is what we can do with workload tools. I know this is a bit complicated, and it's not easy to fit in only 5 minutes. But if you go and have a look at the project and the documentation, I'm sure you will find all the answers to your questions.
Awesome. Thanks, Gianluca. This has been really interesting to me, someone who's not super familiar with benchmarking, but from what I can tell, when we compare what it used to be like versus what it is with workload tools, you've really taken out a lot of the steps that, a lot of the complexity that is there. And also, you've now enabled us for scenarios like analyzing workloads in Azure SQL Database and Azure SQL Managed Instance. Now, one of the questions I came up with as I was kind of watching your demo is, could I use this to kind of, as I'm migrating to Azure and I'm trying to figure out what size I should go to as far as vCores or DTUs, can I use this tool to kind of figure out what the size of my workload is?
So not directly looking at the analysis data alone. What I suggest is to start with the smallest setup that you think will fit your workload and replay. And as you go on with the replay, you can see in real time what the performance numbers look like, and you can go ahead and increase the resources for your Azure SQL DB or managed instance and see if that is enough as you go and analyze the workload.
Got it. So I can kind of leverage this tool to kind of see, am I right size? And if I size up, how does that affect my performance and that sort of thing?
Yes, exactly.
Awesome. Cool. Well, thanks so much for coming on the show. We did put a lot of your resources in the description. So if you are interested in learning more about workload tools, be sure to check out those links in the description. Feel free to leave us a comment to let us know kind of what you're doing with workload tools. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed MVP Edition.